Hello for Thursday. It's January 5th, and the market's on Wednesday. Not too bad. Pretty good consolidation here. After the breakout, the Dow on the day before, whatever that was, Tuesday, I guess, we had kind of a mild day, very tight range. It closed up 21 points. That's okay. That should look good. Of course, when we had that little candle over here, it dropped the next day, but that wasn't after a breakout. So obviously, this is the area to watch here. If we hold above that, then we're going up. The volume also was okay, about normal. For a 60-day average at least, which is okay. It wasn't less than that. And, of course, being a short week, we thought it might be lower than it is. So not a bad day. And a lot of stocks behaved okay as well. Some of them are still coming up and then not staying up as much up at their highs. But you can see here we've got the Dow Futures 60-minute chart. You can see it did pull back. Not quite, but almost to this support line right here. This is its breakout line. Came close to that and then moved up. And then late, the last half of the day, it did move up above this little parallel channel that it was in. And that's all within inside this other parallel channel as well. So we've got a couple things going on there. Here's a look of the SPX as far as the daily chart. You can see when the Dow had actually broke higher, you can see the SPX at 1284 over here, 1292 over here. So if it gets above 1292, that's going to be the new level. Beat that high that was set back in October. We can look also at the S&P 500 futures here. This is, I believe, a 60 minute as well, very similar to the Dow, except for you can see this was the gap. And did come down and filled that area. Of course, you could count that as gap, but not really. This was a support area, place to buy, S2 for the day. It did bounce there. Also, if you'll note that this was pretty much established as parallel channel, this really did establish it here as it came down, so it bounced both there, creating this parallel, and also at the prior support, and it did run up. So it was an okay trade. This wasn't a big one, but it was okay. And so now we're going to watch the horizontal right here. If we can break above there, then it's good chances we're going to go back up to that high as well. I think we have a TNA in place of the Russell. We're taking a look here. This, of course, is a 3x bull ETF for the Russell, so it's going to look virtually the same. Also, in a parallel channel, we didn't draw the secondary one here on the 60-minute chart, a little steeper than the others, but still, it came down to touch, has up hit the top side several times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times, and the bottom 4 times now. So you can trade off any of these on the breakouts or on the pullbacks, the shorts there or the longs here, or shorts, of course, if they break, and so forth. And we'll take a look also at gold futures. You can see what happened here. We'll pull back, and then it came up to make a new high, which happened to also be kind of made a new trend line upper. And so now those are both in place. If it does pull back, we're going to be watching. If it pulls back this far, watch this line as well, because we may bounce again. And if you fall, then that, of course, is not such a good thing. At the dollar, here we have coming up the US dollar. So you can see it pulled back and for a couple days, and then it started moving back up again. That kind of kept the market a bit in check. It didn't move up a lot, but it is back over the 20-day. If this starts going, it's probably going to hold the market. Now, someday that relationship might not be quite as tight. There are some times when the dollar could rally a bit and the market rally as well, and we did see that happen recently. And here you can see that little red candle there on the Russell itself, not much activity. And gold, which we just looked at, here's a longer-term chart of. As you can see, it's moved back up under the 200-day. So that's resistance. When it tried that before, it broke over it, then it came back down, came up to 1643. So right now it has both the 200-day, then the 50-day above that at 1624.73. That's the 20-day moving average. So both of those resistance, and you can see, let's go over left, that resistance. So the good thing going, or the one thing going for it, did have increased volume, but the fact that it couldn't break over it maybe suggests we're going to pull back. But we do have the Williams is broken back up over the 80 line, so that is a possibility that this is just going to continue from here. The GDX, of course, which the day before Went long and this continued higher as well. Not much, it just went up 6 cents in SOV is on the long. This on the mechanical trading SOV is long as well. And I think we can show it. There you go. And it was up, actually, I guess it was down just a little bit of 44 cents for the day. Okay, so let's go to the equities and see what happened. We had, again, like yesterday, we had, well, I don't know how many, seven, eight, nine. On the homepage, stocks that triggered, and some of them moved really nicely, and some didn't move a lot, but they continued the day. But other ones that were new today, like Atlas Energy here, you can see up about close to 4%, but it was a nice clean break and increase in volume as well. So if you miss these, they may move a second day and then maybe pull back. So watch the support as they pull back. When they have increased volume like that, if they pull back and hold that support, that's a good place to buy them, because once again your stop can be tight there. So a lot of that depends on the market and the group as well. SIGA, another one that had good volume, more than average volume, 1.1 million shares. It just closed over yesterday at the 50-day, a little bit over it, and then today it pulled back under it, but not breaking yesterday's low, which is important. And a good area to buy as it moved up with increased volume. CT, wait a minute, let's see what we have here. Yeah, CTAS, actually, we should have showed yesterday, but you know, this had actually broken by pennies recently, but then today was the day that it moved up quite a bit more, another 3.3%, but you can see it was a nice move. So was ITMN. It didn't close up at its high. It was closed up 5%, but it was up higher during the day. The increased volume says it's likely we're going to the 20-day. If it can break above that, it could keep on going maybe to 16 or eventually even to 17, but it's going to need some even bigger volume. But first off, I think the 20-day be the area to watch on ITMN. ASNA triggered. It also, the day before, triggered just a little bit, but it had increased volume, which tells you it's probably going to try again. It sure enough did. It moved up 3% also, and maybe that's it. Oh, and of course, we mentioned this yesterday, but it just went sideways. I didn't show that again. LAZ, and KBE also was one that had gapped up, but today came down closed, came down to the support and moved up above that, so that was another opportunity to buy. Maybe there's one more. I think ARIA, maybe ARIA. This one as well had moved up the day before a little bit there, and that looked very positive. And sure enough, today it continued. It didn't. This is why I say late in the afternoon, a lot of stocks are pulling back. So they moved up really nicely on the 5-minute chart. We're showing some on the share page, and then they pulled off. It still closed up for the day, but not as much, 3.75%. Okay, additions to the watch list now. CMC moved up nicely, about 4% for the day. It's gone into this area. It could be a continuation. I think, I don't know what we're calling it, but it's a continuation right from here, as you can see. And I'm just looking to see if I can see what we, I can't. 1476 is the, all we write down is the high side, but it can be a continuation right from this little trading 30 cents in that area. CSCO is a possibility. 1913 would be the top level. If it breaks over there, you can see it was there back in November. It's moving back up there again. Some recent talk about tech. Maybe Cisco's doing things right. Anyway, just chart-wise, it had increased volume as it moving up, so that is a possibility. CW was also 1740 would be the high of the day, and you can see the first move would be up to this gap around 1775 or a little bit above. So the first would be kind of a scalp, but an okay one of maybe, you know, 40, 50 cents. We'll see if the volume is strong enough, then it may move right above that as well. DEXO, we've traded that. It's been a while since we traded this. We've had pretty good luck with this in the past, but we missed this little rebound down here. But it's come up, and, you know, it's a low-price stock. If you like that price stock, over back over the 192, and basically it's right at that, but up over that little area there, or just wait for it to move up over the 205. That was its high of the day. And it did have increasing volume, which is encouraging. GPS, another one that we traded quite a number of times in the last year or so. The gap And 1907 is the price to beat there. You can see 1914 it was before, but I don't think that's going to be the resistance point. I think this is the area to buy. It had increase in volume. Now remember, this week they will be talking about retail sales. Of course, that's going to be for December, but that may inspire people to buy some more of the retail. And of course, job numbers will be out this week as well. HUM over $90.70. Another one set up pretty nicely. Had increased volume on Wednesday. Like to see that. NS adding to the watch list for a move over 58. You can look left, see 58.96 was a high in the past briefly, and then it pulled back. So just be aware of it. I don't know if it's going to mean much, but if it moves over 58, just know that it may only move a dollar, and if it starts pulling back, you can take some early profits on it. But if it has good volume, that may run. So those are the normal ones. I did want to point out, I didn't have a particularly point on Jazz, but Jazz Pharmaceuticals, you know, quite often this can do a pretty big move. I don't know after 5.5% up day whether it can continue, but I pointed out I'm not putting it officially on the watch list, but we'll see. Maybe if I didn't mention it, it would run for sure, and I wish I had. So I know quite a few of our watchers or readers or whatever do trade this from time to time, and it's a, you know, if you get in right, sometimes it's good. We'll see if that continues. So anyway, that's what we have for this Thursday. Now the week's going quick, huh? So I hope you have a great day trading. Thanks a lot for watching. And we'll be sending out tweets in pre-market and when the market's going as well. So hope they're useful. And we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas also. So thanks a lot. See you then. Bye.